by 10, 34 to 24.
Okay.
And they accumulated 22 of those rebounds in the second quarter. So the work on the boards has been able to kick every waters in this game and give them a slight advantage as we open the third quarter up here again.
All right. Almost a bite. It seems as if they've gotten going in the wrong direction to start off the second half.
They got the arrow. They got the arrow backwards.
Yeah, that's the referees missed that one on that. They almost had a half-court violation just to get this started, but luckily they stopped at the table to get the directions correct.
Yeah. Maybe they must have forgot to switch the arrow at halftime, so...
It happens.
as they get together to figure it out, and our public address announcer Joshua Jackson plays the theme to Jeopardy while they figure this out. And Josh is on the roll over here.
That's another one of the rappers for you. He'll do it every time.
Hell no. There's something about that hill down there in Tallahassee. That quiet sense of disapproval.
Yes, there you go. Not to offend anybody, but we're going to make our point known anyway.
Exactly. As they bring the coaches over here to explain to them what the heck is going on and why.
All right. Question is, are they going to put the 20 seconds back on the clock that started off since nothing really came into play?
I'm pretty sure they get that reset when they get it figured out. Where it depends. If it's Dillard's ball, they're going to leave it where it is.
Right.
If it's Evan Waters' ball, they'll probably reset it.
And for the looks of things, Dillard will be taking it out of bounds to finally get this second half started.
All right, now we got all that worked out, Gary.
All right, Pounds handling the ball up top for Dillard for the Blue Devils. Oh, good defense. Good hustle by
Mia Lake. Leading scores at halftime, Gary. Taylor DeWitt leads Dillard with 6 points in the half. And Latoya Ransom and Laquaza Glover both have 5 for the Evan Waters Tigers. But leading the Tigers is Alexis Seiler with 9 points. We have a shot clock violation right there. Once again, great defense by the Lady Tigers of Evan Waters. Brown pounds the ball up top, gives it over to Glover. And we got a little bit of too much pushing going on down there, but they're just going to sit us in the post.
Ball being inbounded by LaQuanza Glover. Outside the right, they're looking to set up this offense, trying to get something going in the second half.
With the
nice run inside, but it was blocked partially by the defense, by the Blue Devils. They're pushing up the floor against the Tigers. We're going to see what they can do. Three-point attempt up and off the backboard. I don't know if she called the bank shot, but they'll give a three.
But, you know, that's the second person who's gone glass today.
Uh-oh, they brought the glasses with them.
They brought the glasses with them, and they're using them at the bank.
Okay, that'll make it. The bank is still open right here in the gym. Right-hand side of Evan Waters College Gymnasium. Another shot up inside, but a little bit off.
That was Silo.
That was Silo on the inside trying to make something happen. Shot up by Dillard. Rebounded by Light. She's pushing it up the floor for the Tigers. Good pass to the inside. And another pass over to Glover. Now, Glover and Ransom are used to doing that. I saw them playing together when they played for Reebok. High school here in Jacksonville 7 years ago that won that Dick's Sporting Goods National Championship. So they used to communicate the pass and that ball together.
Hey, you know something that's good about this Evan Waters program, they have been good at keeping some of the local talent from Jacksonville.
Oh, yes, they have. And Reebok has been a feeder program for them for quite some time. one of the best programs in the state of Florida.
You know, they do get one every now and then for rain, too.
Yeah, but I don't use that type of language when we're in the stadium right there. Plus, I must be a trumpet if I'm talking about them. You know how that goes.
I got you.
But that's how we work it out. And Rain's program is producing some very good numbers this year. One of the top programs in this area of the country.
Got to put a little bit more air into that pass.
Got to make a better pass inside the Ransom. Blue Devils pushing the ball back up, trying to set up their offense.
Up in the Piles with the basket right there. You know, Mia Late scored her 1,000th point of her career in the last game, Gary. And she's been in a little bit of rut in this game. Hasn't been able to get to that 19-point average that she has on this season. And she's only the fifth Lady Tiger in the 2000s to get to that 1,000 point in her total career.
Oh! In and out by the Blue Devils. Ball being pushed up by Glover. She hands it off to Brown. Let's see if we can get some offense going for the Lady Tigers. What an understatement to have that many points scored by Lighty. Like you said, accomplishment very few women have done here at Edward Waters College.
And we say in the modern era because they only started digitizing their records in about 2002, 2003. So there may be other players out there who scored 1,000 points.
Exactly.
And if you do know of them, please send that information over here to the SID so he can get that updated.
That's correct. Referees seem to be letting them get a little bit physical inside. They're not calling very many fouls on the inside. They're letting the ladies play.
You missed the first half. They called them all.
Maybe they got a little bit winded. They're trying to get their win back there.
It blew the pee out the winter. All right, over to Ransom.
Ransom.
That's a two-pointer.
But it's in and out. Rebound.
And that's what she does.
She puts it back in there.
And that's what she does good. Averaging 9.8 rebounds per game.
BWC up 30-29 over the Blue Devils of Dillard.
And Edward Waters has done a good job switching their defenses up, going man and going zone, but they're going man right now. Step back three.
Oh, rebounded by the Blue Devils. A little bit of hammer problem inside. Ball goes over to the Lady Tigers as they push it up the floor, looking to the inside. Shot up, but it's no good. Rebounded. Ball is going to remain in possession. According to the referees, they call a foul on the inside.
And we've got a media timeout right here, Gary. And we're going to do the same, taking a timeout right here on the Black College Sports Network.
Texas and I have a good red meat blend. Texas Cowboy Dust is designed for steak and other red meats. It's out to be my most popular spice blend, made with onions, peppers, ground mushrooms, pink salt, and other spices. Texas Cowboy Dust also goes great with chicken, pork, vegetables, and adds a restaurant quality sheen to gravies and sauces.
A gentleman wanted to do the Black College Sports Network in partnership with the HBCUs.
Let's face it, shopping for insurance can be time consuming. That's why when it comes to your auto, home, and life insurance needs, make things simple and trust the experts at Allstate. They will help you get the coverage that fits your needs while helping you bundle your life, home, and auto policies. Bundling saves you money, sure, but it also saves you time, so you can enjoy the things that matter most even more. Contact me, Tammy Haynes, your local agent, for free personalized insurance.
We're back here at the Adams Jenkins Center on the campus of Edward Waters University. EWC up 30-29, 4:53 remaining in the third quarter.
Emma Waters just could not break away from this Dillard team, mainly because neither one of these teams is shooting the ball worth the crap.
That's correct.
You know, this Emma Waters team is putting up 80 points a game, and they're only at 30 with 5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Dillard is putting up 68 points a game. They're a little bit off schedule, but they're still within the neighborhood.
They throw one up trying to avoid the shot clock violation. Actually, that was bad by the table because the ball did hit the rim on that. EWC pushing the ball up. Ransom has it in her hand. She passes it off. See if they can set up a little bit of offense.
Yeah, that horn may go off, but until you hear that whistle, you got to keep playing. Finally, only the second three-pointer of the day. This time for Alexia Bell White. You can't lob the ball over there like that against both teams. They got lucky with that pass.
Especially with Laquan's Glover. She's a hustler. They're lucky they got away with that one. Shot clock winding down to 5 seconds on the Blue Devils.
And one thing you don't want to do is shot clock under five.
You don't want to foul.
Don't need to foul right there. All you got to do is play good defense. You're going to force a bad shot. Unless it's a layup, and there was no layup to be given up like that.
Ball inbounded underneath by the Blue Devils.
Great high screen right there by DeWitt. 3 seconds, 2 seconds on the shot clock, long three. Draws iron. Board goes over the Searles. And they're off and running. Great job by Dillard getting back to slow down the Lady Tigers fast.
Pass inside. Jump hook up and good.
The art of the jump hook shot. You don't see that in these kids anymore.
Indian Searles on that last shot. Timeout on the floor.
And this is going to be a media timeout, so we're going to do the same right here on the Black College Sports Network.
It's a soul food restaurant located in the historic West End. Q-Time Soul Food is a family business started by Fred and Christine Crenshaw. Come on in, relax, and sink your chops into our tantalizing, mouth-watering, distinctive soul food with a twist, the Q-Time way. 1120 Ralph David Abernathy Boulevard, or call your order in at 404-758-2881. Do you miss your mama's cooking? Then come on down to Q-Time, an Urban Passport member.
Remain here in the third quarter. Emma Waters has opened up their largest lead of the day. It's up to 6 points, Gary. And they continue to put the pressure on. Brown deflects the ball out of bounds. It remains Dillard basketball. 27 remain on the shot clock.
Good push defense by the Lady Tigers. Dillard still trying to come up with a little bit of offense. They haven't come up with anything this quarter.
And once again, Evan Waters has switched defense. They're back in the man-to-man this time.
Back them down. Bank shot up and good.
And did you see the pump fake there?
I saw the pump fake. It was wide open there. She hit him.
Great fake by DeWitt. Glover, Brown, over to Ransom, back to Brown.
Miscommunication.
To the first row.
To the first row, miscommunication there.
To the Emma Waters, Ben's assistant basketball coach over there.
Brown thought Rumble was moving in one direction, but she saw her going the opposite way and threw the ball at the wrong person. That person's not in the game.
So you mean she zigged when she should have zagged?
She zagged the wrong way.
High screen. Great heads. Great heads by Ransom.
Bumble to the inside.
By Sir Rose and Bill White.
Good block.
Good block on the inside. Off to the races is Ransom.
Oh! Too many passes.
And not only do you throw too many passes, but then you get frustrated and don't hustle back on defense.
A little bit of frustration showing on the part of the Lady Tigers.
And there's mistakes like those that have allowed Dillard to remain the game. Great look up ahead to Brown.
Brown with easy layup, and she converts it for the Lady Tigers.
Assist to Glover.
37-31. The Lady Tigers still lead by 6 points with just about 15 seconds left in this quarter. Largest lead in the game right now.
Yeah, at six once again.
At six.
Yeah. They're down to the game once again. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Just play good defense. And you'll get what you want, is it? They're off to the races.
Brown takes it all away. She puts it up and she's fouled on the play.
You know, I wonder what kind of battery she has in that motor right there.
I don't know, but she's an energizer.
They are energizer, buddy. Do have a battery.
Smallest person on the court, but she's full of energy.
You know, you remember that cartoon on Saturday morning of Speedy Gonzalez?
Oh, yeah.
That's what she looks like when she's going through the defense on the other team.
Not able to convert the first free throw, but she's has two. Trying to widen this gap. Second shot is up, and it's good.
Now Evan Waters has his largest.
7-point lead for the Lady Tigers.
7-point lead. And I'm pretty sure Dillard will pound out these last 28.5 seconds.
If they can get the ball up, but this pressure that the Lady Tigers have been giving us, full court press, has really been giving Dillard a bit of a problem.
Now they switch back. They switch to a 2-2-1 press this time.
Seconds left in this quarter.
Captain
Dillard's trying to come up with some offense. They pass it to the inside. Just at next, she puts it up, but she misses everything.
You know, we've had a great series of air balls here today, Gary. Ransom for this corner.
And Ransom makes it right before the end of the quarter.
9-point lead for the Evan Waters Lady Tigers. The largest of the day. Right here from Adams Jenkins Center. We'll be back in just a moment. Florida, looking at the stats through the third quarter. Dillard continues to shoot poorly at 19.2% for the game. Evan Waters has improved They're shooting. They're up to 36.4% shooting. And neither one of these teams is able to hit free throws. Both teams shooting at about the 60% clip. Turnover by Ransom. And that's going to be an and one. Paige Williams, who they're going to get a personal foul to. Which is going to be on Brown. They give it to Glover. They say Glover hit her upside the head. Right there. Your leading scorer through three quarters. Is going to be still Alexa Sada with 9 points. Glover has tied her also with 9. Late has 7 for the Everwater Tigers. Leading the way for Dillard. Taylor Dillard with 8 points. And you've got a trio with 5. And a West Diana with 3 points.
Lexia Bell White with 3 pointers. Time to break y'all there, but she broke us off with that 3-pointer.
Yes. Rosa Davis also has 5 points for Dillard. That 3-pointer right there brings Bill White to 8 points on the day. Laquanza Glover is 1 point away from another double-double as she comes into this quarter with 9 points and 12 rebounds. Leading the way is Ever Waters has dominated the boards here. 44-32, Gary.
Laquanza is always full of hustle. She has to. She has a parents in the stand. And Reverend Glover's not playing anything by this little girl. He wants to always come out and do her best.
And what church is that he's a Reverend of?
That is, I have to remember, he's up in Brunswick, Georgia.
Okay. That's all right. We're going to let you slide on that, but we just make sure that you see him on Sunday.
Yeah, he's gonna get me when he finds out. We got into the ministry about the same time, about 24 years ago.
There you go. You know, Gary, while we got these ladies playing out here today, even though we got orange and purple and blue and black and white and everything out there, today is red and white day.
Here it is red and white day.
Yeah. Happy Founders Day to the ladies of Delta Sigma Theta.
Yeah, I know Coach Charlene Wilson is feeling it right now. I know she wants to give a couple of oops anything over there right now, but she has to coach this game, and she's probably going to be full of them later on.
As you know, she had the Delta Red on doing shoot around today.
Oh, I know she probably did. Congratulations to those ladies.
And while I look over to my producer, Roy Evans, the brothers of Phi Beta Sigma just had Founders Day earlier this month.
Yes, we did. January the 9th.
Oh, my bad, Gary. I forgot you were blue and white also.
Yes, sir. As a matter of fact, I pledged Mr. Evans.
Uh-oh.
Yes, I did.
Hey, y'all keep that quiet now.
Yes, sir. We don't want to get them nervous up here.
Hey, you know, they can still get you for haze in 20 years later.
Yes, sir. They sure can. Maybe Blue Devils trying to do something in this game. They push it back up the floor. 3-point is up, but it's a little bit off. Rebounded by the Blue Devils and put back in. They're trying to get back into the game.
That was hard on the putback.
Lady Tigers still leading 45-37 over the Blue Devils of Dillard.
Skip pass.
Another 3-pointer up. Right. Just a little bit short.
And that's been the theme of the day, Gary. Just a little bit short. All these jump shots by both teams have been just a little bit short all day. You know, this number one team really gets up into their opponents when they're playing defense. They give them no room to breathe.
Shot up and rebounded by the Lady Tigers. They're pushing up the floor. Here comes Laquanza Brown. They're still looking. Shot up by Ransom, but it's just a little bit off to the right.
Yeah. they're just going to take their time. They're going to make sure that they get something good so they can get into this lead. That was not good. You can't.
That was not the one they wanted.
Now, I mean, it would have been a good shot if she would have bounced herself a set of feet before she released the ball, but she shot it falling away. You're not going to hit that shot 9 times out of 10. Unless you're LeBron.
Unless you're LeBron or James Harden.
KD.
But that step back is not working for her. She needs to step back into the game plan.
Brown for the corner.
Rebounded by the Lady Tigers.
Bill White.
Oh! Not the greatest of shots.
And you can't get frustrated there. It's just like, where's my call? Where's my call? Wait. Offensive.
Yes, that offensive was a call.
That was an easy call right
yes,
there.
Yes, it was. LeBron's around a little slow getting up after that call, but great hustle to get a feet placed.
And you can tell this Evan Waters team works on taking charges. That's the second charge that they've taken today. And both of them have been textbook.
Lady Tigers moving the ball up the floor, trying to set a little bit more offense. They still lead 45-37 over the Lady Blue Devils of Dillard.
You know, Glover just did a great job just getting in the air and saving that ball to save the possession. Reverse layup.
Deponza Brown fouled on the play.
You know, the only thing I'm going to say about that, Gary, when she came through, she should have went to her left hand instead of coming back to her right. Yeah. She goes to her left hand, she's probably at the line for an and one. Love at the line for two. First one is up and good. You know, this Evan Waters team on the day, it's only shooting 54.5% from the free throw line.
Gotta work on that. Games won at the free throw line.
One.
Can't just give away those 3 points.
Won and or lost.
Yes, that's correct. That's correct. Second shot up. And it's in and out. But there's a violation.
And you know, I don't think anybody from the Tigers has hit 2 free throws in a row today. Let's see if she gets it on the violation. See if she can go ahead and make up for it.
Yes, she does. Yes.
That opens up now the largest lead of the game at 10 points. Just over 6 minutes remain in the ball game.
Alexis Sowler back into the game for the Lady Tigers. They're still pressing.
Whoever goes checks the trainer for just a hot second. You ask her if you're okay. Another turnover by Dillard.
A little bit physical on the inside. And it ends up being an offensive call.
It's a kind of foul on late.
Yep.
Trying to sneak in and get the rebound.
But she was late on the rebound. She lived up to the name on that one.
Oh, man.
Ball was getting in the hands of the Lady Blue Devils of Dillard. 5 minutes and 50 seconds left in this one, ladies and gentlemen. Shot up. No good rebounded by the Lady Tigers. Brown comes back to get the ball to push it up for the Tigers.
Evan Waters works one time, but they still want to stay within that river. And they're going to take opportunities for breaks.
3-point attempt up and no good.
I think that ball just slipped out of her hand right there.
Yep. She seems a little bit gimpy as she gets up off the floor.
Nate Farley with the 3-pointer. And we're going to take a timeout. And it's going to be, we're going to take a timeout right here. And We'll be back on the Black College Sports Network.
It didn't. What happened was a gentleman wanted to do the Black College Sports Network in partnership with the HBCU for these black colleges.
Absolutely.
And it would have educated the Black College Sports Network. This is what he wanted to do. That would have educated a lot of black kids. Mm-hmm. Okay. That was the real reason why I got into it, was when I saw what happened with the Black College Sports Network.
Majesty is a premium health and wellness tea line focused on bringing delicious yet healthy tea blends to the community. Filled with an abundance of vitamins and antioxidants, we work to blend teas with exotic spices and fruits to produce scrumptious and wholesome beverages. So check us out at mymajesties.com. That's MYMAJESTEAS.com. My Majesty. Perfect. Now we
have just over 5 minutes to go here at the Adams Jenkins Center. Your Everwater Tigers up by 13 points as they open up, expanding the lead. And that timeout right there may not have been the best timeout in the world for Everwaters. They had a media timeout coming at the 5 minute mark, but they called a timeout with 5:07 remaining.
Nate receives another foul on that play.
But, you know, they played the non-conference season without the media timeouts. Mm-hmm. Now they get in the conference season, they use the media timeouts. So it is a little bit of adjustment, especially if you're not used to playing with them. You have to remember
exactly
how to say those timeouts for later on in the game.
That's where your assistant coaches come into play. They got to let the coaches know. She got to concentrate on calling the game.
But you're assuming that the assistant coach also knows how to use those timeouts wise.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Maybe she'll listen to the broadcast and she'll be able to say, hey, those guys are trying to help me out a little bit, and she'll be able to do
definitely
a little bit better than the rest of the season.
Definitely, because
that's what they're there for. You got to let the coach coach, and you got to do those little small things that make a dividend in the game.
Yeah, definitely. You know, you've got to be able to manage those timeouts. There's going to be a game that's going to be close where you may need that extra timeout.
That's right.
One shot remaining for Dillard. And Dillard can hit two in a row, unlike Edward Waters.
They did on that play there, but
there's Diana McNeil.
The Lady Blue Devils trying to press the Tigers. Tigers pushing the ball up, but they break through the press, pass to the inside. Laquan Glover up, and it's good.
Hey, you know what's scary about this Glover girl is that she has one more year eligibility remaining.
Yes, she does.
So, you know,
her recovery like would not be there. Yes, sir.
That's the second 10-second call today. Gary, I haven't seen two 10-second calls all year basketball, and I have seen two in one game.
Yes, sir. A little bit of a disciplinary problem. They got to work that out. Got to do a lot better.
Clock awareness more than anything.
Yes, it is.
And you talking about that assistant coach?
Mm-hmm.
That assistant coach has got to be the head coach ear.
Yes.
Call the timeout.
Yes. Good drive to the inside
with the left hand. Excuse me, that was Brown.
That's Brown, the energizer.
They're at 25. They get it over this time.
3-point attempt by the Blue Devils, but it does not go in. They rebound on the inside, puts it up, and there's a foul on the inside.
Two-shot foul.
And then Searles with the foul on that one.
That's her fourth personal. Quanza Hunter at the line for two shots.
First one's up and it's good.
And we've got subs at the table.
Second shot up, but it's no good. Rebounded by the Lady Tigers. Brown trying to push the ball up. Pass inside to Silas. She passes it back outside. Looking down for late, but she has nothing in the corner. She brings it back up to the top, try to set the offensive up. minutes and 30 seconds left.
They're running that triple weave. Glover with another rebound. Glover a little bit slow getting up and hustling back.
Oh!
And they get Brown for slapping a hand on the foul zone. It's trying to close out. We're going to have three shots here.
Three shots.
Check it back into the game for Evan Waters. Natel Ransom checking in for Dillard is Taylor Banks. You know, looks like Emma Waters, they're 3 minutes away from getting a revenge from last year's championship game. But I guarantee you, Emma Waters will trade this victory for that victory back last March.
Oh, yes, sir. Oh, so bittersweet. First shot up and good.
Third shot is going up by McNeil.
And it's good.
3 for 3.
The latest Tigers leading 54-43 over the Dillard Blue Devils with 3 minutes and 7 seconds
left. Great job by the senior pulling it out.
Not much on that shot by Ransom.
Gary. The 25th letter of the alphabet. That would be Y.
Why did she do it?
Thank you.
No need for those shots right now.
You know, this is our first time doing a game together, but Gary, I come up with obscure analogies like that every now and then.
And I must have just had a birthday because I started counting from the wrong end. I should have just put one back. And I would have been the Y. Why did I go that way counting? Ball inside the silence. She tries to put it up. Second attempt also not good.
Glover's a little slow. Now she's holding her shoulder. You know, Glover has not been healthy all season long. She's and it's not been a major injury, but she's had little nicks and bruises all year long. And it would be amazing to see if you had a healthy LaQuanza Glover.
Timeout called by the Blue Devils.
And let's see. It's going to be a 30-second timeout, so we're going to stay here. You know, they've cut this lead back down to 11 points. You know, they're going to need to, the Blue Devils are going to need to stop right here, and they're going to have to score pretty much every possession out in order to try to catch these Emma Waters Tigers. For Emma Waters, all they've got to do is play good, consistent defense, and they'll go home with the victory.
There you go.
As we look across at the bleachers directly behind the paper, you see the ladies from Delta Sigma Theta celebrating their Founders Day as they're strolling in the bleachers.
Yes, sir. Brown controlling the ball up front. Oh, she trips.
She trips.
She maintains control of the ball. Timeout called by Coach Wilson.
And this is going to be another 30-second timeout. We're going to stay here.
Can one girl in a small town, an architect in a major city, and a suburban high school coach shape the future of the United States? Yes, they can. Because every 10 years, the census gives us that power. You can shape your future by responding to the 2020 census. Where do we need new roads to make our lives easier? Where will new school programs help our children thrive? Where could a new health clinic benefit neighborhoods? The 2020 census will inform these decisions and shape how billions of dollars will be distributed to communities like yours each year. And in 2020,
right here, Black College Sports Network, coming to the bottom of this game here with the Amber Waters College Lady Tigers against the Dillard Lady Blue Devils. Amber Waters leads right now 54-43 with 2 minutes and 35 seconds remaining in the game.
And Amber Waters likes to run this dribble weave in the fourth quarter. And all you're going to see is them passing the ball back and forth to the guards at the top of the key.
That's all they need to do.
And then whatever will look to turn the corner, get into the lane, and either score or dish it off.
That's right.
And that is the fourth team foul on Dillard. They'll be shooting, you know, both teams will be shooting the remainder of the game on the next foul by either team.
Late inbounds to Brown. Brown pushes back late. Late puts up the three-pointer, and it's good.
And she shot that with confidence.
Yes, she did. Yes, she did.
She said, fourth quarter, I'm the senior. It's my time.
Yes, sir. Leadership comes up front.
Oh. She turned her head on defense. She had to steal. She turns around. Lexa Siler with the foul. Just a half step slow on that one. Be a two-shot foul. At the line is going to be Taylor DeWitt.
You know, if Amber Waters is not careful, this is a way that Dillard can slowly sneak back into the game, even though there's only 2 minutes to go.
Yes, sir.
Because you get an opportunity to score with the clock not running. But you got to hit the free throw.
Got to hit the free throws. DeWitt misses on the first one. Second shot attempt. It's up. And it's good for the Lady Blue Devils.
Now, Dillard does what they're not good at least this year, is coming with the full court pressure. Because the pressure has really not bothered Amber Waters all day from Dillard.
Good pass to the inside from Laquanza Brown. And India Searles is fouled. She'll be going to the line.
And she's mad at herself that she's not the line for the and one. She was concentrating too much on the contact and not enough on the make. Yes.
Both teams in the penalty. She'll be sitting two. First one's up and good.
As the band yells out their traditional EWUC on a make.
Oh, second was up. It's missed, but rebound by Laquanza Brown, and it's good.
Glover, that was good.
Glover, that's right. Laquanza Glover.
And you know, she's got to be pushing 20 rebounds on the day, Gary.
I mean, how many people do you know have more rebounds than points? But that's what hustle does for you.
Yes.
Hustle brings.
Especially when you're in double-digit points.
That's right, that's right. Three-pointer up. No good by the.
There's another rebound for. Six-point lead for the Lady Tigers. They called an offensive foul. I have to watch that again, Gary.
Yes.
I thought the defender may have been in the restricted area.
Yeah, she looked like she was moving.
She looked like she was in the restricted area, whether she's moving or not.
Right.
So that's what that semicircle is there for.
But we never see the referees change their mind. So ball down low being brought in by the Lady Blue Devils of Dillard. 1 minute and 6 seconds left remaining in the game. Amber Waters leads 60-44. And
now we got a steal by Glover.
Bad pass to the inside.
Now that's the way you pull out a run clock right there.
Ball knocked out by the Lady Blue Devils. Inbounded by Glover. Good hustle once again on defense by the Blue Devils.
That's number 10, Deanna West. Now she's going to let the point guard. She's going to let the best ball handler take the ball out.
The Energizer Bunny's going to have the ball in her hands. Let's see what that energy does for her.
Watch Sila diving right here. We're going to have a screen by Lake.
Referees trying to get together what they want to do. Ball pass there inside. to Glover. She passes it back to Brown.
She's going
to
pound as much of this shot clock down as she can.
Three-pointer, not necessary, but up and no good by
that's not
Layton.
Your leadership right there. Thus, you have the turnover. But that's how she plays. She's an aggressive player, and she continued to be aggressive.
37 seconds left in this one, ladies and gentlemen. The Lady Blue Devils get the ball inbound, and they're moving it up the court. Ball pass to the inside. Just play confusion there. The back out.
All you
got to
do is play defense.
Shot is up, and it's good by number 21, Taylor Banks.
Dillard calls a timeout. It's going to be a 30-second timeout, but we're going to take a quick short break here on the Black College Sports Network.
Census online, by phone, or by mail. It's easy, safe, and important. Make sure you and everyone you know is counted. Now is the time for you to get involved. Your community needs you. Together, we can educate and excite, inspire and make sure every voice is heard. Together, we can shape our future.
Now you can live in Texas and not have a good red meat blend. Texas Cowboy.
Seconds remain here in the Adam Jackson Center, fourth quarter. Your Everwater Tigers up by 14 over the Dillard Blue Lady Blue Devils. Home run ball and that's the exclamation point. And this Everwater's team is still pressing with 27 seconds left to go. They're trying to take the spirit out of the Lady Blue Devils. They're getting everything they can to avenge that loss from last year. And they're still off and running. And they're going to hold it. They're going to dribble it out for the last shot.
Bad pass attempt, but it doesn't matter.
And it's no good.
And that's going to do it. The Everwater College Lady Tigers win this game 62-46 over the Lady Blue Devils of Dillard University. Right here on the Black College Sports Network. We're going to take a break. We'll be right back with you shortly.
It's designed for steak and other red meats. It's out to be my most popular spice blend, made with onions, peppers, ground mushrooms, pink salt, and other spices. Texas Cowboy Dust also goes great with chicken, pork, vegetables, and adds a restaurant-quality sheen to gravies and sauces.
A gentleman wanted to do the Black College Sports Network in partnership with the HBCUs.
Let's face it, shopping for insurance can be time-consuming. That's why when it comes to your auto, home, insurance needs, make things simple and trust the experts at Allstate. They will help you get the coverage that fits your needs while helping you bundle your life, home, and auto policies. Bundling saves you money, sure, but it also saves you time, so you can enjoy the things that matter most even more. Contact me, Tammy Haynes, your local agent, for a free personalized insurance quote. Allstate, are you in good hands?
Q Time is a classic Atlanta soul food restaurant located in the historic West End. Q Time Soul Food is a family business started